So what exactly does GeoJSON look like, especially once we load it in with D3? Just as with our previous charts, we simply set up our margins, our width, and our height, and we append an SVG element, this time with class map, to our page. And now we can put in a debugger, so we can pause execution and inspect what geodata looks like and the structure it has. As you can see here, we've loaded our globe.html file that we were just looking at in the browser, and execution has paused at line 22 in the debugger. Looking at what geodata is, we can see here that it is a JavaScript object with top-level keys, type, with value feature collection, and features that corresponds to an array. And again, another one of the benefits of using GeoJSON is that it's simply a JSON file that we can pass around like any other. In this case, we can even load it in with D3's standard JSON data loading function. And when we inspect it in our console, we can see here that the Chrome Web Console treats it like any other JSON and gives us this nested structure to inspect through. We can see here that in the features array, there's 177 items, each of which itself is an object that has a geometry key and a properties key. The properties in this case has a single key value pair that's the name of the country. In this case, the first one is Afghanistan. What makes GeoJSON unique is its shape extensions. Here we can see each country has a geometry key that corresponds to an object that both has coordinates and a type. In this case, the geometry of a country is a polygon, as we can see here, and coordinates is an array of values, or rather an array of arrays of two elements, or pairs of coordinates, representing the longitude and latitude of the country. One thing to note here, and it's not explicit, is that longitude actually comes first, in this case, what's labeled with 0, and latitude comes second, what's labeled as 1 here. And that's just a quirk of the format. And this geometry object that has coordinate points and the type polygon represents the border of a country, in this case, Afghanistan.